What's up, guys? I'm the Nearsighted Gamer, and I'm bringing you the second of my E3 2015 recap videos. Once again, I apologize for the quality. I had to use my webcam. Sorry, but at least I sound good, right? Yeah. All right. This time, we'll be focusing on Ubisoft and Sony. With Ubisoft, they once again went with Aisha Tyler to host it, and for the most part, I think completely that she did a good job. Either she fakes it well, or she really likes games as much as she says she does, because she was very convincing that she was really into every one of these games. That she talked about. Everyone that would come out, she would be like, oh, this is awesome. This is awesome. I can't wait for you guys to see this. Yeah. So, she did a very good job convincing or lying. One or the other. I think she did an okay job. Alright, on to what I liked and what I didn't like. They started off the press conference with a surprise that nobody saw coming. Nobody. You couldn't have even predicted it because of what they said. They started off with a South Park game. And it's called South Park: The Fractured Butthole. Yeah. It's a continuation of the Stick of Truth, which I loved. Loved. If you like South Park and you haven't played this game, what is wrong with you? It is great. It's so funny. Hilarious. I was laughing the whole time. It was great. It looked just like you were playing South Park. It was like a season of South Park. And the gameplay was really good. I loved it. The sound, they had the concept, they had the world. They had everything. You could tell that Trey and Matt were heavily involved, which they were. It was really good. And in this one, it's a continuation, and instead of playing wizards and all that, you are playing superheroes now. So, Kun and Friends and Professor Chaos. Oh man, you have superpowers. This is, if there is any direction they could have went with this, it's here. I was completely surprised, as were a lot of people. So, I definitely want this. And this is going to be on PS4 and Xbox One, I'm assuming, not PS3, which did fine on PS3, but it'll do a lot better on PS4. Oh, I'm definitely going to play this. I loved it. What we got next? After that, there was a new game, a new IP called For Honor, which seemed to be not really medieval times, but you could pit, you know, knights against samurais in these big battles. You could have teams of, I think it was 5 or maybe 4 playing, and you'll get scattered out in these battles, and your team is trying to take out their team, and like there's people all over that aren't really on teams that you're fighting. They showed a trailer for it, which was pretty cool. Nobody knew what the heck it was going to be. And then they showed gameplay with people playing live, and it seemed really good. It's good to see a new IP that has my interest and isn't just something of something else. I mean, of course, this type of game has been done. Like, there's no way to not do. It's very hard to do a completely original game that hasn't been done in any shape or form. But this one looks like it's gonna be pretty good. And I'm pretty sure it'll be on PS4 as well. And probably even PC. More than likely, like a lot of games are being done these days. They talked about The Crew. Some DLC for that, I assume. There was a trailer, a small teaser trailer. Not my type of racing game. Talked about in the last video. Trials Fusion. Awesome, Level Max, Pass. More about The Division. They showed a pretty good gameplay trailer of it, and it made me want to play it even more. Like I said in a previous video, this might be another shooter that the Nearsighted Gamer ends up getting into, and if you knew me, that's huge to get to have my attention and want to play one of these. The gameplay on it was super awesome. Like, I can't even... Wow. And they showed a release date for it. Of course, it's going to be next year. What date was it? I should have wrote that down, idiot. But they did show a release date. I think it was March. I think that was March for that. Yeah. I could be wrong. If I'm wrong, correct me in the comments. I'm sorry. It showed a game called Anno, which some kind of city builder. Immediately passed on that. Not really interested in that. Of course, it's Ubisoft, so Just Dance. And they did indeed Just Dance. Jason Derulo came out and sang for real, which I'm glad I was just watching and not there, because those people had to deal with it. There's no telling how much money he got from them just to come out there and not entertain anybody at all. But hey, there's people up there who like Just Dance, and well, it's still coming. Something about not needing a camera, being able to use your smartphone, Just Dance Unlimited, some kind of streaming service. I didn't pay attention to that. Sorry for anybody who wanted more information on it from me. You're not going to get it. That's my bad. Sorry. Rainbow Six Siege. This is another game that I'd heard a lot about and kind of wanted to play a little bit. I'm very familiar with the Rainbow Six series. Haven't played any, once again, shooters, but a friend of mine who was deep into it, and he was always playing it at my house, and watching him play, it looked great, but I knew that I would not be able to do what he was on. I tried to play like a few times, and like, I didn't suck completely, but I wasn't really having fun, so yeah. But it, once again, sorry, it's the old standby, it looked great, and the gameplay looked fun. If I could pull that off, and then yeah, maybe with the the game's going next gen. Well, they've already been next gen. What I mean is, with the level that games are arising to now, maybe it will make it easier for people like me who normally don't play for certain reasons, able to, you know, come in and get into the game more. Yeah. Hopefully so. It had my attention. There was just a trailer, and there was some gameplay. They had Angela Bassett come out, I think. Is this the right one? I think this was the one where Angela Bassett came out. Yeah. She was part of the trailer, and then they showed sieging, you know, shooting a guy, going in, using all kinds of cool tech to accomplish a mission. What else? Ah, yes. A show, Trackmania. Yay, Trackmania. Some kind of DLC. They did a small gameplay thing for that. People were entertained, I assume. I was not caring. And then they showed a trailer for Syndicate, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which has become their yearly cash-in thing now that they do. I have Unity. I haven't even beaten Unity. I wasn't, privileged enough to have any of the bugs, so that wasn't the reason. It's just, I still plan on it. I really do. It's a shame that I haven't. But other things came along, other games, I started doing this. So when you're making content about games, it's kind of hard to play games just to play them. So I still haven't beaten Unity, and this looks great because of the time period being the Industrial Revolution, the things that they have to pull from that they can use, it's becoming modern. Like they said, this is the first modern Assassin's Creed. So that, with that aspect, that does have my interest peaked, but I can't let myself get it unless I've beaten Unity, at least beaten it. Not collecting and completely mastering the game, that's wow, there's too many things. But I can't let myself do that without at least beating Unity. It's just the way I am. And then at the end, they surprised everyone with Ghost Recon Wildlands, which, wow, what was the last Ghost Recon game? I might be missing one, but it seemed like there hadn't been one in a while. More shooters. This one didn't have the appeal to me at all. No Ghost Recon game ever has, actually. But they're interesting to some people. This was the first time it was released. There hasn't been anything about this before. So with just a small trailer, well, actually it wasn't pretty small. It's pretty elaborate and good. But just with a trailer, I need to wait for there to be more about it. Even if they're, I just want to see more, but I don't plan on playing it. Shooters are not my thing. Alright, now we move on to Sony. Oh, Sony, you made me very happy. Thank you, Sony. Thank you, Andrew House. Thank you. You say, oh crap, I can't say his name. Shihei Yoshida. Yeah, there you go. Thank you. Okay. This is how they started the press conference. They came out talking about a game, about a hero, friendship, and then they cut it. And then you saw Japan Studios logo, and you saw a feather. I was like, no way. Are they gonna do it? Are they gonna put the rumors to rest? And then they showed a gameplay trailer for The Last Guardian. Yes, they did. What, you don't believe me? You can go see it for yourself. They did. That's how they started off. Started it off with a gameplay trailer, and my interest is again peaked. Again, I said it in my video that curiosity was what's keeping people there, and yeah, now I'm even more curious. So, who's the guardian? Is the kid the guardian, or is the rabbit thing or whatever who can make dramatic catches and catch the kid in slow motion, apparently, is he the last guardian? We don't know, but they did say 2016. So by December of 2016, by December 31st of 2016, you can have The Last Guardian in your hands. You can be playing it on your PlayStation 4. PlayStation 4 exclusive. Boom. That's how they started it. Oh, man. I couldn't believe it. That was great. So they rocked that, got applause. Everybody was like, what? But they kept going. They kept going with stuff. Guerrilla Games, who I didn't mention in my what I expect to see video, because it slipped my mind. They had been working on the game for years, a long time. And they finally showed what they've been working on. It's a game called Horizon Zero Dawn. They showed a trailer and gameplay. It's this, I guess it's not really post-apocalyptic, but just after this great disaster, the world changes from, you know, city-like, like the cities get overgrown and they go back to the way it was as far as, you know, forest and living off the land and all that. His technology, for the most part, is what's gone, and it reverts back to that. So there's like these tribes of people who have to live off the land and go and hunt. But they have forms of technology, and they hunt these robots, these robotic animals. It's a really cool concept. To see the kind of weapon she was using, what you saw was a girl from one of the tribes hunting this big, it wasn't a dinosaur, of course, but this big lizard type. It looked like a dinosaur, I guess, a robotic lizard or whatever. You saw her stalking it, and she made her way up, and then she went to attack, and it shows her fighting and using different type of weapons. She was using mainly her bow, which is some kind of mechanical bow. Different types of guns, and then she would like tie it down, and she tied it down into one spot to be able to, you know, get to it better because she was getting attacked and she couldn't get in a good shot. And she came in and she stabbed it and took it down, and she won. And then at the end, like, she was standing up there and there was like a robotic bird that came behind her and she was fixing to fight that. Yeah. Yes, please. Something new. Something that looks good, and it's on Sony, it's on PlayStation. Yes, indeed. That is two for two, Sony. Thank you. What else? Then they showed a trailer for Hitman, a short trailer. I found out you can watch a longer trailer online, and Hitman's cool. I played a couple of Hitman games. They weren't really my thing, but I'm not knocking. I'm not saying they're bad. Just not my thing. You know how certain games are yours. Some aren't. Sorry. The trailer looked really great, though. The way they did it was really stylish and methodical. Back and forth. It wasn't just a straightforward, here's Agent 47. And he's killing people. Blah, 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 blah. You know, they didn't give away anything as far as the story, so it keeps you more intrigued. All you know is Agent 47 is back, and after Absolution, which I believe is the one where he went rogue, I think. Yeah, so he's back. So I don't know what happened at the end of Absolution, or if that even matters, and the thing that brought him back was the beginning of this. But yeah, they showed that, and that was pretty cool. Then they showed a trailer for two new characters for Street Fighter V, which were Birdie and Cammy. Birdie! I remember Birdie from Street Fighter Alpha 3. I didn't play just regular Street Fighter 3 Third Strike, but I remember from Alpha 3, and it was weird. But to see him in a game of this level, as far as, you know, the complicated moveset and how things work, it'll be cool to see how he fits in. And Cammy, of course, there's no way Cammy's gonna be there. They just keep dangling characters. Just dangle us a Rose. Come on, give us Rose. Anyway, another one that I mentioned, No Man's Sky. I said that I wanted to see what you were doing, instead of just flying around, and what was your goal. They talked about the goal. The goal is to get to the center of the universe. And, yeah, it's going to be pretty hard because they showed you in a solar system. A solar system. They showed the star of a solar system. So there's planets around it. And then they, like, zoomed out and showed more planets. And they zoomed out more. And they just kept zooming. And he said that all those dots were stars with their own solar systems and own planets. You can go to all of them. This is nothing new. I'm just recapping what he said. You can go to all of them. He showed him going to one. He went to one planet and he went. You can go and explore and take records of it. He showed a little bit of space combat, like very short video of space combat. I have to go back and look at it myself. It was that short. But the goal is to get to the center of the universe. Then you can trade, you can fight. There's a game there. There's some game there. It's not just, ooh, look how pretty this is and look how big it is. Even if I don't get it, I know someone close to me who will get it, and I can make my decision based on that. So, yeah, they showed off more of how big it is and talked about getting to the center of the universe. So, yeah, there's No Man's Sky. Once again, it does look great. It looks really good, and the concept is awesome. I just need a reason to play. Just, that's just not enough.
What else?
Me and Molecule showed up, and there was no puppet dangly move controller show going on. They showed off a new game they called Dreams, where once again, it's player driven, where you can create dreams, as it would be. I'm trying to explain this. Take dreams, you can sculpt objects and people and make dreams. You can go into other people's dreams and, you know, make adventures of your own. I recommend going and watching the trailer for this one. I'm doing a terrible job of explaining it, but you know, if it's Media Molecule, then it's going to be good, because they're good at making stuff that they're good at making games where you do stuff. Like, you're going to have to play their games to enjoy them. So if you just want to be carried through, then Media Molecule usually isn't for you. But it's good to see them coming up with something, showing something. That was pretty awesome. What else? Firewatch. Yeah, pass on that. They showed a trailer for, I guess, the next expansion of Destiny, the Taken King, which showed like new weapons. Was that a new class? Different types of enemies, because Oryx is super pissed that you killed his boy Crota, so he's coming to get you, and he's bringing his posse with him, so you're gonna have to fight. Yeah. I don't know, Bungie. I don't know. Of course I want to play it. And you're gonna end up getting me to do it too, aren't you? It looked great. It Destiny 1, the first Destiny looked great whenever they put all that crap together and all those trailers. That's how they got you. And of course, I'm not saying, like I said, the first Destiny, but when Destiny first came out, I know this isn't the sequel, but yeah, whenever that comes out, I'm probably gonna play. I'm not gonna lie to you. I still haven't gotten House of Wolves, but I'm pretty sure gonna get that, because there's a whole lot that was changed in that. That was a very drastic change. Like, there's stuff in there, like story content DLC, not just a few and some weapons and all that. Like, yeah, so this comes out like September, so yeah, they got some months to work on it, and it's not like they just started working on it, so yeah, I'm probably gonna play it. I'm not gonna lie. I saw another Assassin's Creed Syndicate trailer. This time it was about Jacob's sister Evie, the sister and brother twin, Jacob and Evie Fry. And might I say, I think I'd rather play with Evie if I did play the game. She's got like a sword cane, she's got throwing knives, she's really quick, she can kick some freaking ass, man. Like, dude, those poor people, I'm so sorry. Not to take anything away from Jacob, like, dude can clear a room, and like, clear the room, he's like, come on, let's go, Rook's with me, and like, he went into a place, like, got a chair, sat down by himself, talked shit, came, ended up fighting, took down the leader, and then left, and then the guy's people left with him. Evie just dropped up in there and said, what up? And then she started, like, slicing and killing people. It was pretty cool. Like, the combat was great, for sure. They made Evie look pretty cool. Get to play as a chick now, so I know a lot of people are happy about that. That was great. Where are we? No, pass on that. Now we get to the other one. Like, this was the second time my draw was dropped. The first one was The Last Guardian. Then they showed this trailer, and they were talking, and, like, you couldn't really see what was going on. if you were really paying attention, you would be able to pick it up. But, like, you know, you don't know what's going on. You're going and showing people. They're talking about something about them coming back and all that. And then you're on the back of a dude, and then you see this huge sword on his back, and he's walking out, and you see blonde hair. It's freaking Cloud. They are doing a Final Fantasy VII remake. HD remake on PlayStation 4. Not that crappy PC port. Screw that. They are doing one on PS4 for the PS4. And oh my gosh. I cannot wait. They didn't show a date, or I missed it because I was too busy drooling. Final Fantasy VII. Oh gosh. Oh, that I gotta go back and watch that. I haven't watched it since then because I started like getting stuff together for this video. But oh, that felt so good. That was one of the surprises I was talking about. Yeah. Okay, what else? They showed some stuff for Arkham Knight, like some bonus missions. With the Scarecrow exclusive to PlayStation. Just like last time when Arkham City came out, there was some exclusive stuff. If I said Arkham City, I meant to say Arkham Knight. Both. If I said Arkham Knight, I meant to say Arkham Knight the first time, if I didn't say it. Black Ops 3, whatever. They talked about Disney Infinity 3.0 and Star Wars. It's going to be two play sets. One's focusing around episodes. She said 1 and 3. What she means is like Star Wars. Well, no, she said the Clone Wars. Yeah, so it's going to be that. Then there's going to be one for the future one. So, like, I'm sure my kids will want it. I might end up getting it just to make sure my kids will want it. Because you get to, like, fly and fly ships and all that. All the stuff from Star Wars is going to be made in Disney Infinity. Like, all the toys. It's pretty cool. I already knew about it, but I didn't know much about it. Found out about the two play sets. So, that's great. What else we got? Oh, and keeping with Star Wars, move on to Star Wars Battlefront. They showed a super cool gameplay trailer for that. A regular trailer and gameplay. I can't believe how good that game looks. It looks super good. That's the power of the PS4. I can't believe I hadn't said this whole time, but that was the power of the PS4. That was a super cool game. Didn't play Battlefront on PSP, was it? I think it was. Mainly because, any game where you had to look around and shoot on the PSP was pretty bad because shoulder buttons and you had to use the control pad and it was terrible. So even if I'd wanted to, I wouldn't have because I know how bad it would have been. But, this looks good, and it's Star Wars, and it has my interest, because they were taking down all kinds of crap, and it was super awesome. Vader was there, And then, they finished the show with a little game called Uncharted 4. And after having to restart the demo, because Nate just wanted to stand there. Anyway, after they restarted it again, we got to see gameplay of Sully and Nate in some city, and they spotted a tower off in the distance where they had to get to, so they ran off and they got to a vehicle. Then they were being chased by, they got ambushed by people and they were shooting them off, so you saw some gunplay. And then they came out with they had a truck with a machine gun on it. So they had to run. They got into a Jeep. And then from then on, it was like a chase trying to lose those guys all the way down while also trying to get to the tower. It looked really good. There were some huge jumps. Like, the detail in that game, like, after seeing, Uncharted the way it is and all, it puts it the PS4, like the detail on Nate and Sully's face, like, hey, let's see Sully in the cigar. But it looked great. It didn't look like it was having any problems with all the crap that was going on. It was super great. All that was needed was the chick from part two. Yeah, I would like for her to show up in this game so I can see what she looks like. But that was all for their press conference. And I said that I wanted to be satisfied by Sony's press conference, and I was indeed satisfied. I was satisfied by Sony's, and I was satisfied by Ubisoft. I really like what Ubisoft brought to the table, what they had to offer. EA, they had some good stuff. Yeah, but not as much. And Microsoft. Mostly, the majority of the things they're going to show, they're going to talk about, are going to be exclusives. So even if I were to like them, I won't be able to play them because I don't have the Xbox One. But they did do a good job with their conference. I believe that just minus the Jason Derulo crap, Ubisoft did a good job. Aisha Tyler, she's been there for like 4 years, I think. So apparently they like her and people seem to like her, so she was okay. EA was EA. Ducked out on a lot of things because there was a lot of sports involved, but they were showing what they had to show, what their brand gives and makes. So yeah. And then Sony came out and made my night, man. They made my night. All I have to look forward to now is tomorrow, or the next video. Tuesday's video will be Nintendo and Square Enix. Square Enix is what I really want to see. I want to see what they're going to talk about. This is the first time. They have a lot of things. I know they're probably going to talk about something Final Fantasy related, or if not, that's of course what I want. But they're not just that. They have other properties and other things. Maybe they'll bring back X. I'm joking. I'm so joking. Don't bring back X. Just let it die. But that's the end for this video. Thanks for watching. Like it if you like it. If you don't like it anyway. Because I said so. Comment on it. Positive, negative, whatever you had to say. I want to hear it all. Subscribe to the Nearsighted Gamer if you haven't done so. Like my page on Facebook, facebook.com/TheNearsightedGamer. So you can stay up to date with what I'm going to do in case I decide to do something spur of the moment, something crazy. Whatever. Thanks for watching again. Later, peeps.